Welcome to Mastering Solutions. This is a motion on a ramp problem, and it tells us that we begin sliding down a 15-degree ski slope. Ignoring friction and air resistance, how fast will you be moving after 10 seconds? This problem, it's a fun problem, but it's actually kind of tricky. At face value, it seems like it really wouldn't be that bad. But once we get into it, it's not a lot of calculations, but it does require you to understand some key concepts that can be kind of confusing at first. So we have our little ramp here that we're going down, and they tell us that it is 15 degrees. Let's draw our little person here. We're coming down here on our skis. Okay, so here we are coming down this slope. And what we're going to do is to do the tilted coordinate grid. So we want to, let me do this in black just to show you. This is going to be our x-axis, and then this will be our y-axis. So it's not going to be perfectly horizontal and vertical. We're shifting it so that the x-axis is perfectly in line with this degree slope here. I know my picture is slightly off, but you understand the idea that we're going for. Now, the thing that's confusing is this step right here, where gravity, we know, pulls straight down. I drew that really long just so we have some space. So this is negative g because it's in the negative y direction. And what we're looking for is this speed right here, the x component. And what the key component is, it's kind of tricky to understand, is we're looking for the x component right here, which will give us the acceleration down the hill, because we have gravity right here. So this will give us the x component of gravity. This degree right here is the exact same degree as right here. If you remember back in your old math classes when they would do these parallel lines and they say this angle is the same as this angle and this angle is that angle and these are complementary to this one and et cetera, et cetera. This idea is what we're doing right here. Now, don't get too stressed. It's really helpful to go through and to think about why this angle is this one. For the sake of the problem, you can just accept the fact that they are the same. Like I said, it's a really good practice to go through and figure out how to get them the same, because that will come up a lot in later chapters. But for this, let's just say they're both the exact same here. So now, looking at the trigonometry functions for this x component right here, we have the angle, and this is opposite to it. So this is a right angle right there. And so this, or g, will be our hypotenuse for this triangle. So we'll be using sine, which is sine of the angle theta is equal to opposite over hypotenuse. Now we want to find the opposite. So let's multiply both sides of the equation by h. So the opposite is equal to h sine theta. And all that seems pretty straightforward, right? But the opposite right here, we could rename that to acceleration, because that's really what it is, right? That is what is causing us to speed up as we slide down the hill. So the acceleration, we could say in the x direction if you want, is equal to h, which our h is g. So we have g times the sine of the angle, which in this case is 15. We put a negative g right here because it's going in the negative y direction. Our acceleration is going in the positive x direction. So I'm not putting a negative g here just because our acceleration needs to be positive. So don't let that confuse you why this isn't a negative g. This is a really good example of understanding when it should be negative and understanding why we put a negative g versus here we put a positive g. It's because it's positive x and negative y directions. So now acceleration in the x, we can plug our values in. We know it's 9.8 meters per second squared. And then we'll times that by the sine of the angle 15 degrees. So we have 9.8 sine 15 gives us 2.54 meters per second squared. So this is how fast we're accelerating down the hill. So now we need to take that information and plug it in up here and say, okay, how fast are we going after 10 seconds? We'll use kinematic equations. The one we'll use is the acceleration formula. So we have v final is equal to v initial plus acceleration times time. If you're confused on why this is the acceleration formula, we just broke up acceleration is equal to the change in velocity over a change in time. Multiply time over, so we have delta v is equal to acceleration times time. Broke up this into v final minus v initial equal to acceleration times time. And then we added v initial over here to this side. I know I went through that super fast, but we went over this a ton in the last chapter, so that should feel more like review. The initial velocity is zero in this case because they tell us that we begin sliding down a hill, meaning that we're going to assume that we started at rest and then we start to slide down the hill. So the final velocity will be equal to the acceleration that we found. So we have 2.54 meters per second squared times the time of 10 seconds. So 2.54 times 10, and we could just move the decimal place over one. So we have 25 meters, which is how far we've gone after 10 seconds sliding down a 15 degree ski slope.